My presentation regards a quantitative methodology to assess the process of electric power service and infrastructure recovery in power system, and it's done from a collaboration between RSC and the Italian TSO Terna. After a brief introduction about the need for a resilience concept, we briefly describe the TSO practice to face emergency situation, the requirements for a quantitative model of recovery process. After that, we propose the model for the recovery process of the infrastructure and of the electric service. We apply this to a case study and discuss some results. Extreme weather events strongly affect both the infrastructure and the electric service of modern power system, and resilience in this regard is a key concept to help operators face this emergency situation. In particular, both the operators and the regulating authorities are interested in accurately evaluating the resilience technical indicators, the former because they wanted to exploit in the best way the incentivation mechanism, and the latter because they need to check the fulfillment of the imposed requirements. So, in order to have an accurate evaluation of the resilience indicator, we need a quantitative methodology to model the process of the recovery of the system infrastructure and electric supply. In particular, in the presentation, we focus on two threats affecting the Italian power system, that is wet snow and tree fall events. And regarding the wet snow, the TSO current practice include the weather forecasting to be for anticipation and preparation, smart allocation of maintenance crews and the provision of special equipment like tracks, cranes, a special training for the usage of such equipment, and the planning of adequate amount of resources. A quantitative model for requires the modeling of the time period when the emergency occurs, the weather conditions, if they are good or adverse, the viability of the roads, if there are obstacles like fallen trees on the roads, the accessibility to the fault, if the fault is close or far from the roads, the type and number of failed components, if they are towers, conductors, it, the availability of spare parts and means like cranes, trucks, cars, special cars, the evaluation of the time to locate the fault and to reach the location of the faulty element, and the operating condition of the survived power system. Each component is characterized in this model by a total recovery time divided in, composed by 5 time intervals. T1, that is the time needed to locate the fault. Time 2, that is the time needed to decide how many resources are needed to fix the problem. T3, that is the time needed to transport spare parts. T4, the need time to transport the maintenance crew. And T5, that is the time needed to repair the faulty elements. The total recovery time is given by this relation in the bottom of the slide. The methodology is divided into two modules. The first module regards the simulation of the recovery of power system infrastructure by identifying the sequence of recovery times of damaged components on the basis of a Monte Carlo sampling simulation that is applied to exogenous factors, in particular weather factors, in order to derive the probability distribution of the 5 time intervals T1, T5 that I mentioned before for each damaged components. We have also assumed that faulty elements close to each other are in charge of the same maintenance crew, because this is a practice of the current of the Italian TSO. And the methodology also allows to assign M clusters of faults to N different available maintenance crews. The outcome of this module is the sequence of recovery times of the damaged components. Given this sequence, we apply a load flow based robust algorithm in order to evaluate the service recovery process by reconnecting one by one the damaged components according to the increasing recovery time. And we check the fulfillment of security constraints. So the independent factors at the basis of this framework are the changing environmental conditions, so the weather in terms of precipitation rate, wind speed, and so on, fixed environmental factors like the slope of the terrain, so the orography, the presence of trees, the availability and preparedness of resources like crews, special vehicles, and so on, and the operation condition of the survival part of the system, OP. Many of the variables in this framework depend on the above factors. In particular, the type and the number of failed components depend on the weather condition, on the operating condition of the system, on the orography, and on the intrinsic vulnerability of the components. The time interval for fault location, T1, and for travel times, like T3 and T4, depend on weather condition, the viability of the roads, on the presence of the resources, like cars, vehicles. And also the accessibility to the faults depend on the weather, on the presence of trees, and on the orography. The repair time also depend on weather condition and on the availability of maintenance crews. So, in this model, we consider two paths, essentially, to evaluate the travel time. The first one is the path between the maintenance crew office and the faulty elements, lambda one, and the second is the path between the inspection crew's office and the substation, because in order to locate the fault, we need to send an inspection crew from this office to the substation to poll the relays and to check the location of the fault. Each path, lambda one and lambda two, is divided into two parts. A first part, L11, that is where the crews use a vehicle with a nominal speed V1N in good weather condition. And the second part, L21, where the crew go on foot because they cannot go farther with the truck. And so they need to go on foot and to transport spare parts up to the faulty elements. In this case, the nominal walking speed is V2N in good weather condition. A similar decoupling division for lambda two. The weather matrix is fundamental because it considers the time evolution of the weather variables of interest to evaluate the phenomenon. In this case, essentially the wind speed, the precipitation rate, and the temperature. Given the coarse granularity of the available data, we focus on the evaluation of the time evolution of weather variables only in three points, that is, at the location of the faulty component, in the location of the maximum stress intensity along path lambda one, and in the location of maximum stress intensity in path lambda two. Moreover, we consider other environmental factors like the slope of the path, lambda one, and the average slope of the path, lambda two, and the presence, the potential presence of trees close to the roads with a linear density of tree coverage. So the time interval T1, T5 depends on the weather conditions. In particular, the travel times like T3 and T4 depends on the derating of the walking speed and the vehicle speed according to the weather conditions. Because as we know, the walking speed depends by the slope of the road, the amount of accumulated snow, the intensity of the wind, and the visibility that is defined according to the formula on the right. Also, the vehicle speed depends on the visibility, the amount of accumulated snow, but also by the potential fall of trees that block the roads. We also use this notation that is important for the following. So, in order to evaluate the derating of the walking speed according to the slope of the terrain, we use the Naismith relationship in the top part of the slide. Instead, in order to evaluate the derating function of both the walking speed and the truck speed according to the different weather variables, we use an exponential function like the one in the formula in the bottom of the slide, where in this case this is applied for wind speed, but also it has been applied for the visibility and for the snow accumulation. The typical form shape of the rating function is like this for the walking speed, and this is the derating function of walking speed as a function of the wind speed in a specific location. The threefold modeling is based on starts from the modeling of the individual tree fall fragility curve, that is a log normal distribution centered on a value of wind speed limit that is linearly decreasing with snow accumulation. This means that the distribution goes towards lower limit wind speed in case there is an accumulated snow on the tree. Moreover, we evaluate the probability of any combination of Y fallen trees according to a binomial distribution, taking into account the remaining path between the current tree location and time t and the fault location. This remaining distance is given by L1z minus the integral of the track speed V1z, and the total track speed along the generic path Z is given by the formula in the bottom part of the slide. Ty represents the time interval when a combination of Y fallen trees occurs. After that, so the total derating function for the walking and track speed for all the weather and environmental factors is given in the top part of this slide. Consequently, all the interval T1, T3, and T4 depends on the weather condition, depending on the walking and track speed above. Also, the repair time T5 is a function of the visibility and the wind speed in the location of the faulty elements. We also can manage multiple repairs, taking into account that each maintenance queue is responsible for a group of faults consisting in faulty elements closer than a radius of 5 kilometers. The recovery time of the cluster is the maximum of the recovery time of each faulty elements composing the cluster. And an algorithm also to associate NT NG faults higher than NT crews to the NT crews is given in the bottom part of this slide. Essentially, we attribute the NT cluster of faults to the first NT groups, and subsequently, we attribute the further cluster of faults, NT plus one, to NG, to the crews according to an increasing, according to the first crew that stops the first round of repairs. The recovery of electric service done using a robust power flow based algorithm, which reconnect one by one all the components, giving priority to radial connections with the lowest recovery time. In case the reconnection caused the security violations, this component is disconnected and it will be reconnected together with the second component at the second lowest recovery time in the sequence. And we repeat the reconnection of all the elements until 95% of Orange supplied customers are restored. The case study concern an emergency situation in February 2015 with the same weather conditions as in this emergency condition. We model the weather variables as a Gaussian with a Gaussian uncertainty and the zero mean around the forecasted values. We also consider the worst weather conditions by multiplying the recorded condition, the forecast conditions for this real case by 1, 2, or 3. And we consider these condition upper limits for the wind speed, for track speed, and man walking speed. These case studies are considered the recovery of a single faulty element, of two close faulty elements in charge of the same maintenance crew, three far faulty elements, and with L maintenance crews, and the recovery of the electric service in the fourth simulation. In this plot, we find the PDF curves of the time intervals composing the recovery times. In case of moderate weather conditions, G1, we find essentially a recovery time that is has a low variance around 5.6 hours, that is also in line with the recorded maintenance times recorded during the event of 2015. In case of moderate weather conditions, we have an increasing high wind probability, which affects the travel time, T3, as you see, and consequently, there is also a larger variance in the recovery times between 6 and 7.3 due to high wind probability along the path. In the worst case, we have also an increased probability of fallen trees along the road, which stops the trucks and requires the removal of the trees from the roads. This implies an increase of T1 time for the inspection crews, which ranges from 0.4 to 1.2 hours, and the travel time of the maintenance crews, T3 and T4, up to 9 hours, and the total recovery times are move towards 16 hours. In case of two faulty closed elements, we see the PDF curve of the travel times, in particular T3, of the two faulty elements. We see that they are separated by a time interval that corresponds to the repair time of the crew around 4 hours, plus the time needed to go from fault one location to fault two location. In intermediate weather conditions, the median value of the total recovery times passes from 10 hours to 12.1 hours, and due to the strong decrease of the truck and man walking speed due to the high wind condition. In worst weather conditions, we have again a high probability of three falls on the roads, which increments a lot the T3 travel time and consequently the total recovery time, whose median value goes up to 19.9 hours. In simulation,
Andre, sorry yes? to interrupt you. You only have 3 minutes left, yes, and that's counting the questions, okay?
Yes, okay. I have finished, thank you. Essentially, in the simulation number three, we have three faulty elements far from each other, with passing from one to two maintenance crews. The median recovery time passes from 19.7 to 11.5 hours. We have also simulated the recovery of the electric service. Essentially, in this case, we have two HV line feeding a substation with a 7.8 megawatt load. We have two median values for the recovery times of 6 and 10.5 hours, as the reconnection of the first line allows to supply all the customers without any security violations. We can say that the supply service recovery time is 6 hours. So this framework allows to quantify the dependence of the recovery process timing with exogenous factors, both weather and organizational factors, and allows both an ex-ante evaluation of the recovery times based on forecast and the sensitivity analysis to see how this recovery time may be affected by changes in organizational factors. Thank you very much for your attention.